Musings, Wrath and Mercy. Psalm 78, verses 50 through 53 say this. He made a way to his anger. He spared not their soul from death, but gave their life over to the pestilence and smote all the firstborn in Egypt, the chief of their strength in the tabernacles of Ham, but made his own people to go forth like sheep and guided them in the wilderness like a flock. He led them on safely so that they feared not, but the sea overwhelmed their enemies. As I say repeatedly, the English word awesome has been overused to the point of becoming virtually meaningless. And I don't mean to say that as a judgment to those who use it for lesser things. It just grieves me that that there's a loss of words that can adequately describe anything that actually strikes awe into the human heart. One of the truly awesome events in history is God's protection of his people Israel and the breathtaking power that he displayed against those who opposed and hurt them. But something else that staggers the imagination is that even after the Lord raises his mighty arm on behalf of his chosen people, other verses in this psalm tell us of their rebellion against him, if you can imagine that. Verses 58 through 62 say this, "For they provoked him to anger with their high places and moved him to jealousy with their graven images. When God heard this, he was wroth and greatly abhorred Israel, so that he forsook the tabernacle of Shiloh, the tent which he placed among men, and delivered his strength into captivity and his glory into the enemy's hand. He gave his people over also unto the sword and was wroth with his inheritance." How disastrous was their folly. And yet verse 72 demonstrates his faithfulness as he continues to guide his people. It says this, "So he fed them according to the integrity of his heart and guided them by the skillfulness of his hands." We need to be careful not to presume upon God's goodness, but at the same time, we desperately need to rest in his faithfulness and his integrity and his skillfulness in guiding us through the unknown. We have to remember that he is already there in the future. He already knows the way, and he can be trusted to get us home even if he leads us on a bumpy path.